Hello YouTubers, and welcome to this T4D. I, believe it or not, after posting my last T4D, where I was obviously talking about some of the achievements and the little kind of overview of Doug's DMM Check Plus, I went away for the weekend, which is a first for me. Probably I haven't been away in about 2 years, so it's been a busy year on the last channel, and a lot's happened in the last 2 years. So I had a getaway, and I participated in a road cycle race, 204 kilometers, and so that occupied my time for the weekend. So it was a nice chilled getaway, but obviously now it's time to get back and pop in and do some videos. Now again, there's a lot on the boil, so I'll try to quickly throw around and show you the bits and pieces that have been coming in and what's going to happen soon. Thanks again very much to Frankie Tong. You'll have seen in the video snippet this watt meter. This is a Sky RC meter. Now again, it's another mission that we're on. Poor Frankie, I suggested this to him, and the poor man is now out hunting down the ideal power meter. Now the reason I enjoy these power watt meters is that you can easily connect them up in line with a circuit, and you get to see the obviously the voltage, current, power, consumption, and what have you. And these even do temperature. Now Frankie looked at these and he wasn't too happy with the accuracy. I've still got to have a look at them. He's opened one up. These do have external temperature. They do temperature measurements as well. He has got another one in the post on the way to me in an aluminium enclosure, which he's also so-so about. But he has found another one which might appeal more to the hobbyist. So as soon as I've got all of those, we're going to put them side by side with my WhatsApp meters and have a look at those. I'll also then do, because I know folks are interested, is a review on the panel meters I've got. So that'll be coming up. He also kindly donated a few little extra bits and pieces, so to help me when we take a look inside, these nice little sprodges or what have you, to get into when I'm taking things apart. Then again, also thank you very much to Sean B. Sean is a local follower and viewer of my channel based in Durban. He also does brilliant contributions on my forum, and I know he posts a lot on Dave Jones's EV blog. And he sent down, I'm not even going to try and pick it up, you saw it in the kind of intro video, it's a neon light transformer. And that might be interesting for testing the input protection of multimeters, because it puts out a very high voltage, about 6,000 volts if I remember correctly, but at a low current, at 25 to 30 milliamp. Now when I say low current, that is enough to give you to do serious damage if used incorrectly. So prior to me using this, I'll make sure I set things up safely. But that might be part of the input protection testing on the multimeter. And also for fun, we said what we might do is one of the cheaper multimeters is see how they can handle a taser. Also, what I want to do, say, with a taser is actually check, is demonstrate how a high voltage spark can jump across a gap, and that's and show the value of ceramic fuses. I don't know how it's going to react, but it's something we might just set up and see for fun how it works. Then what also has arrived, my good dear wife, Louise, came back from the States at the end of last week, which is why it was a little bit hectic for me. She has brought back the Amprobe AM160A multimeter. Now, thanks very much also to Retired Caps for some interesting input when he saw us getting this, and he pointed me to something else. Now, I particularly wanted the Amprobe. Okay, now this cost, I forget, it cost $200 and something. So not cheap, but it is, by all accounts, a very good multimeter. It's got a 50,000/500,000 count. So really high resolution. Good feel, good display, fast update speed. I've had a quick look at it, but I say you'll see that in the review. And but it's based on what looks like a Brymon multimeter. So it's been rebranded and packaged for Amprobe by all accounts. So the one question is going to be, is it good value in terms of the price? And that we'll discuss in the review, because there might be an interesting alternative which does exactly the same thing. So that we'll have a look at the review shortly too. You'll have seen in the intro snippet, I had it connected up to those solar panels and hybrid capacitors. I'm busy playing around with the solar powered Kindle project as well in the background. I got a car charger, so a USB car charger was brought back from the States as well. I had one and I've gone and misplaced it. So my wife brought one back as well, because the one I had wasn't doing true DC to DC conversion, and the one I've got there does. So I might do a short video and just demonstrate that as I'm working on trying to get that project off the ground as well. Okay, then I have seen a lot of you are like requesting some of the tutorials. In particular, I'm getting a lot of requests lately on queries about people wanting to solar power their homes and taking the next steps. So very soon, within the next week or two, I plan to pick up on the next video in the series of how to solar power my home or your house, because that one will add a lot of value in terms of the questions you need to ask in terms of taking the steps to scoping a solar power system for your home. So that I will do. And then on the electronics tutorial side, I know there's a lot of people wanting to look at transistors, so transistors and FETs. But the step before that is obviously diodes. So that will be the next in the electronics tutorial series. So there's a lot to do. Unfortunately, just there aren't enough hours in the day to pump them all out at once, but I'm going to slowly start plodding through and get the videos done. So again, thanks for your support, and keep an eye open, because we'll start jumping in and doing these reviews and the electronic projects next. Cheers.